very thankful for the assembly and the ministry that the body has to itself, that edifies itself, builds up itself. Something that I had not ever thought of with regards to the Lord's table, with the specificity that I have tonight, and with the intention and the focus, is the possessive form of the word Lord's table. This is His table. And of course, that stands in stark contrast to the table of demons. There's a table that belongs to wickedness, and this table belongs to God. Don't think that there is a table mentioned that belongs to man, because in reality, all men are at one of these two tables. So I want us to think about the fact that not just that this table is His possession, but that He has spread the table. So we're coming to a table that belongs to Him, that He has provisioned. We're coming to eat what He is offering. Let's think about how the Lord has used this word throughout the Scripture, and I'm sure that there's more occasions, more places in Scripture that I didn't think of, but the Scripture says, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. It belongs to Him. By virtue of creation, it's His. So see, thinking in this way about the Lord possessing this, it kind of straightens out your thoughts. The earth is the Lord's. So then think about the precision of the sun coming up in the morning and it's setting in the east. The earth is the Lord's. Think about the cycle of seasons that have been, that don't alter. We never have had a spring and then a summer and then a fall and then a fall and then another summer. The seasons are always, they're faithful. The earth is the Lord's. Belongs to Him. Think about this text. Glorify God in your spirit and your body, which are the Lord's. They don't belong to you. This is a big assumption among men that your body is your own. And it's a lie. Your spirit and your body are God's. And they're our stewardship. And we're going to give an account to Him of deeds done in the body, because the body is the Lord's. In the prayer that the apostles prayed in the book of Acts, at the first persecution, the men gathered against the Lord and against His Christ. He's the Lord's Christ. The Lord sent Him to do His will. Amen. And Jesus came to do the work that God sent Him to do. It was His meat to do the will of Him who sent Him. He's the Lord's Christ. So this table isn't the table of the church. It's the table of the Lord. Amen. This is not the table of the apostles. It's the table of the Lord. In the last prophet, Malachi, the Lord says, they shall be mine when I make up my jewels. So just as you come to this table and you let this word sink down into your spirit, the Lord, this is the Lord's table, and when you consider the brethren, think, they shall be His. See, it sanctifies your relationship with brethren when you know them primarily as belonging to the Lord. It sanctifies that relationship and your communications, and it actually makes you a profitable minister when you consider the brethren as the Lord's jewels. They will be His when He makes up His jewels. So coming to this table and with this fresh in your mind, this is the Lord's table. It sanctifies your mind. The Lord called the land of Israel my land. And he held he held offense towards the people and what they did with his land. It wasn't their land. It was his land. Jesus leveled this accusation against the Jews. My house shall be called a house of prayer. But you've made it a den of robbers. It was the Lord's house. It wasn't theirs to formulate their own traditions and to change everyone's money for the temple coin. And it wasn't theirs to do that in. It was the Lord's house. And God spoke out of heaven and he said, this is my beloved son. He's mine. So hear him. And so no wonder, if this being the case, that he who rejects me, Jesus said, has rejected my Father, the one who sent me. And so when Jesus gave this, he said, this is my blood. He said, so many possessive words. This is the Lord's table. This is my blood. This is my body. And do this in remembrance of me. You see how it all, this table really has little to do with us, except that we've been invited to it. Because it's the Lord's table. So God forbid that we come to this table without a sincere desire for the table. Just think about how, and this has been brought up already tonight, think about how it looks in heavenly places when people come to this table and they have stronger desires for other things than the table that they're coming to. God forbid. So may our thoughts be drawn to the table that we're coming to. May our thoughts be drawn and taken by what the Lord has put on the table. This is honoring and pleasing to the Lord. Jesus said, with desire I have desired to eat this with you. So when we come, God forbid that we don't come with desire to eat this table. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we're thankful for these things that you have revealed about this table. And we ask, Lord, that you would give us grace to be sober-minded as we come to this table. Give us grace, Lord, to examine ourselves and so eat of that bread and drink of that cup. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.